The Columbus Blue Jackets of the last few years have been maybe the biggest enigma in the NHL. They're not afraid to be aggressive in spending their money or trading away picks and prospects for proven players, but they're also always seeming to bring in some young stud player who's going to be the face of the Blue Jackets for the next 10 years. And yet it never seems to pan out. They're always at the bottom of the division, but there's also plenty of ammo on this 23-24 Blue Jackets team to let the asshole haters like me shit on this team. Blue Jackets, here's why I hate your stupid fucking team this year.
I never heard of half of these guys, and the ones I do know are way past the prime.
Most of these guys never had a prime.
This guy here is dead.
Cross him off then.
Now I'll admit, when I was looking at that first line, I was kind of feeling it a little bit. Johnny Gaudreau is a great candidate for a bounce back year, and Kirill Mershenko is one of those very intriguing young prospects who could make the jump into the NHL and prove himself to be a superstar. However, then I saw that this line was being centered by Boone Jenner, which is like putting Dom Toretto into Fred Flintstone's car. But who knows, maybe Johnny Hockey and the young Mershenko will be able to carry that lifeless carcass to his first ever 50-point season. On the second line, it's everybody's favorite. We swear he's going to become the superstar that we all projected him to be any day now player, Patrick Laine. Remember when this guy was being called the next Ovechkin? That's like saying that Ishow Speed's going to be the next Dave Chappelle. He'll be centered by Jack Roslovic, he of 190 points in almost 400 games played. Now on the third line, young hotshot rookie Adam Fantilli will get to experience the joy of playing alongside Alex Texier and Igor Chinnikov before immediately fucking back off to Ann Arbor so he can remember what winning feels like. If there was ever a team that could sap the life out of him and Kent Johnson, it would be the Columbus Blue Jackets, baby. Now, your defense was mostly overhauled during the offseason, other than Zach Werenski, who is a real, honest-to-God, great NHL player, and Eric Goodbranson, who is the exact opposite of that. Now, in goal, Elvis has not left the building. That's right, Merzlikins will be your projected starting goaltender for the year, despite posting an 87.6 save percentage last year. Man, once upon a time, Elvis was the darling of the NHL. Everybody was thinking, hey, this guy could be pretty good if he was on a team with an actual NHL defense. And after last year, everybody's just wondering if he needs LASIK or not.
Anybody got an idea?
Your coach, Mike fucking Babcock, amid desperately trying to fend off accusations that he's Mike Keenan without the fantastic mustache. Seems here, meeting his daughter's new DJ boyfriend for the first time, Babcock built a reputation in Anaheim and Detroit as a no-nonsense leader of men who led the Wings to one championship and reached the Cup two other times. Since then, he spent 5 years in Toronto doing absolutely nothing and revealing himself to be an incredible hack who can't do anything without Nick Lidstrom and Henrik Zetterberg holding back the players he just called garbage. After that disaster in Toronto, he went into hiding, which I guess is the right thing to do when you had 20 former players calling you a miserable old fuck and the worst person they've ever met. And now witness relocation has moved him to Columbus, a place where nobody would think to find a coach who's won a Stanley Cup.
Who the hell are you?
I'm the new guy.
Yeah, like I said, that entire defense got overhauled, and for good reason, given the fact that you trotted Andrew Peak out there for 80 games last year. This season, you went all in on upgrades, making splash trades for Ivan Provorov and Damon Severson. But Yarmo, if these teams are willing to trade these guys within their division, might be worth taking another look at the tape and the stats to see whether these guys are actually worth trading for. I don't know. That's just me. I'm no GM.
You gay Irish fireman, you're okay, but you, I do not like.
Now, like I said before, Zach Werenski is a really good defenseman that the Blue Jackets smartly locked up until 2028. You've also got some good young pieces like Fantilli and Marchenko, and Adam Boqvist is a very promising young defenseman. There are a lot of good young pieces on this team. The big question is how long until they get tired of the promise of the Blue Jackets and expect to see some results. Blue Jackets will probably be better than most people are expecting because Mike Babcock, despite being a massive prick, still has a decent mind for the game. But then word will get out that he refuses to even be in the same room as Johnny Gaudreau, and the whole team will crumble down the stretch, just barely missing the playoffs.